be shopping, decorating, and plenty of snow. Hey, Patrick, who's that under the mistletoe?
Hey y'all, it's your girl Carmen back again with another YouTube video. If you guys are new to my channel, please do not forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Turn on post notifications and comment down below hashtag post notification squad when you guys are done. So today's video is going to be a story time, and I have never done a story time before ever on my channel, so this is gonna be my first time. And it is also Vlogmas day 2, so yeah, period. I made it to Vlogmas day 2. But so today's gonna be a very embarrassing story time, so please do not laugh in the comments or anything, because I was actually debating on if I should tell this story or not, but then I was like, why not, you know? So this story time is going to be a story time on when I like leaked my period in school. And no, it's, yes, it's just a coincidence that I have red on. I didn't mean to put red on, because like, but if you are a guy, or if you feel uncomfortable watching this video, then now is your time to click out, and I'll wait. Anyways, so yeah, without further ado, let's just get right into the video. Alright, so, just like any other girl, it was that type of, that time of month, and, this was when I was in school, like in person, and of course, why would you wear a tan pants while you're on your period? Like, usually you try to wear black pants, but anyways, I had already wore all my black pants for that week, and I think I had like forgot to wash them or something, because I forgot, I don't know, but basically, my black pants wouldn't have been washed in time to like, my black pants wouldn't have been washed and dried in time for school. So I put a lot of pads in my backpack and put some tan pants on. I'm like, okay, I'll be fine, right? I'll be fine. It's nothing. I'll be fine. So, and I didn't want to change, when I got to school, I didn't want to change it to the school pants, because the school's pants, they're like, yeah, like that. But, so I just was like, okay, you know what, Carmen, you're overthinking, you'll be fine, right? Fast forward to fourth hour, it was like, it was fourth hour, and, no, it was third hour. It was fourth to third hour. And I had already went through so many pads. Like, if this is TMI, I'm sorry. But, like, I had went through so many pads already. I'm like, what's going on? I should not be this heavy. Like, should I go home or what? And then I started getting paranoid because I had tan pants on. So, like, it was super duper heavy. And I think the reason it was heavy is because back then, this is when my period was off. It would be, okay, so say this is my period, and then it would skip 3 months, and then it would come back, and then it would skip 5 months, and then it would come back, be regular for a couple months, and then stop. So this particular time, it was because, I think I was so heavy because it was like, it hadn't happened in 3 months, so it was all, you know, it was all coming back. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so heavy. Like, should I go home? Should I go to the nurse or what? I was just like, okay, Carmen, you're over-exaggerating. You'll be fine to the rest of the day, okay? So I just kept going to the bathroom in class every hour, kept going. And I was getting short on pads. Yeah, very short. So I was like, what am I gonna do, right? So, and then, what happened? I think it was like 6th hour I had went and I had got like a little bit of blood on my underwear, but I still had extra pads, so I just changed my pad. I was like, okay, it's fine, it's not noticeable, whatever. fast forward, we go to, okay, so fast forward, we just got out of 7th hour, and I'm walking down the hallway going to my 8th hour class, and I started feeling like heavy, like there was a lot of blood in my pants. No, you know how you got that feeling, you like, you ask your friend, is there blood on my pants? Because that's what it feel like, right? I had asked my friend, I was like, is there blood on my pants? And then she was like, no. I was like, okay, just making sure, because I know what I felt. I know exactly what I felt. And she said, no. I don't know. I still to this day don't know if she was lying or if she was for real, but I really hope she was lying. I mean, I really hope she was for real, because I was just walking down the hallway, boys and girls and teachers just all looking at me. I'm just walking down the hallway, being my normal self, trying to hurry up and get to class. I really hope that she was for real, because I swear, if everybody was looking at me and I had blood on the in the back of my pants. Anyways, I was just walking at 8th hour or whatever, and so my 8th hour class was gym. So, but luckily we wasn't in gym, we was in health. This was in middle school, so we had like gym and health separate. I mean, we had one quarter of gym and one quarter of health. Luckily, we were in health. So we like sit down in the desk and we have our paper and pen and all of that. And we're not running around the gym, which is a good thing. So, because I know what I felt when I asked her. I said, I don't even know who I asked. I forgot. But I know, because I felt heavy. I was just walking down the hallway. I'm like, but anyways, so I had finally made it to 8th hour. I sat down at my desk. 5 minutes later, I felt something wet on the bottom of my seat. Mind you, where I sit, we sat by a bunch of boys. Like, y'all. So I was sitting down and I felt something wet. I said, so you know, I did that little thing, you lift up your leg, you peek, and then I seen something red. My heart dropped. I'm telling you, I said, like, I literally looked and then I said, because mind you, I was wearing tan pants. I didn't know what to do but sit there. I was like, I was sweating, shaking. No, like, when I tell y'all I was shaking because I was scared. That was my first time ever leaking. I was like, oh my gosh, what do I do? What if I have to go up and present something? I don't know. So I told my friend that was sitting next to me, I was like, and luckily I had some of the best friends in my class because they were so supportive. I'm not gonna say their names because I don't know if that they feel comfortable with that, but I had three friends in that class, I don't know. But I told one of them, I was like, I just leaked on myself, I had period blood on the chair. And the chair was red, so that is a miracle. Like, I knew that wasn't nothing but God. The chair was red. Good. I'm so happy that chair wasn't white or nothing. But I was like, I think I had, like, lifted my leg up a little bit and showed her. She was like, I was like, can you go tell the teacher so she don't make me get up? Y'all, I'm so happy that my teacher was a girl, because if my teacher was a guy, yeah, my teacher was a girl, so I was like, can you go tell her that, like, you see? So she told her, and she was nice. She got my paper and my pencils and stuff, so I didn't have to get up. So I was just sitting there the whole time. I was like, I asked her, I was like, can you wait with me after class? Like, my voice was shaking. Can you wait with me after class so I can, like, get up and clean this up and stuff? And then she was like, yeah. I was like, okay, thank you. Okay, so I had my jacket, right? Because I think it was cold. It was winter. So I had my jacket. I had my jacket. And then I was like, okay, I still had it on. I was like, that just ruined my whole entire mood for that class. Because, yeah. And I was just like, But anyways. So the class had went by, the bell rang, class is over. I'm still sitting there waiting till everybody leaves, and I'm also waiting till passing time ends, meaning I'm waiting until everybody's out the hallway and no teachers are looking, no classmates are walking. I'm literally waiting because, like, I'm just that type of person. I don't like to be embarrassed. So I'm just like, okay, is everybody gone? I got up. It wasn't as much. I don't remember, but I got up and I couldn't really see it that much because I told you guys the chair was red. And then, so right when I got up, I put my jacket on and I tied it around my waist. And I just stood there, and the teacher was like, okay, you can go. I have extra pads and tampons, and you could go to the bathroom and change. And then she said, I'll clean it up for you. I was like, oh, you don't have to clean it up. I can clean it up. She's like, no, I got it. I'll clean it up for you. I was like, okay, thank you. So she really did clean it up. And me and my friends had went to the bathroom. I went to the bathroom, and it's like this mirror. I took my jacket off. I'm sorry if this is TMI, but, like, my pants were red. My butt was red. I don't understand how I got that heavy that quick. I think I haven't changed. I didn't change for, like, 2 hours or 3 periods. I went to the bathroom, and I, like, pulled my pants down. I didn't know what to do because I didn't have no extra underwear there. My underwear was soaked. I'm like, ew, like, I literally was finna throw up because if y'all know me for real, I do not like periods at all. I hate them. Like, I wish there was no such thing as a period. I just don't do well with that stuff. Like, ew. But, so she gave me a pad. I think I put the pad over my underwear that I already had, which, I don't know. But I put it on, put my pants up, put my jacket back on. I was still shaking. I walked back to the health room. All right, so sorry about that, y'all. My dad had just called my phone. But anyways, what was I saying? So I went back to the health room, and my teacher said, my teacher emailed the nurse or something. I don't know. Basically, I had went to the nurse, and then, that's what happened. So, y'all, see, I'm just remembering stuff as I go. I had went to the nurse. I had told her. She said, okay, you can sit in my office for a little while. It's like, okay. I don't think she had any extra underwear, though. I think somebody had already took the last pair. I don't know. But anyways, they had called me on the intercom over to school. No. The lady in the office called my name on the intercom. She called it to my classroom, and obviously my teacher was like, she's not here right now. But my teacher didn't know where I was. My teacher was like, she's not here right now. And then the lady on the intercom said, like, okay, just tell me, or I don't know what she said, but anyways. So then everybody noticed I wasn't there. So, I was walking down the hallway. No. Eighth hour was already over. I told y'all that the bell rung. I waited till everybody was gone. And then we had homeroom last hour. So, then homeroom was over, meaning that school is out. So, all the kids are walking out of the school. There's me with my jacket on in the hallway, still shaking, looking like a lost puppy, walking to my locker to go get my stuff. Everybody was like, Carmen, why wasn't you in homeroom? Carmen, where was you at? I'm like, I was talking to my teacher about my grades. But anyways, my health teacher had emailed. Okay, yeah. Y'all, I'm sorry. I'm not good at telling stories, but so I was just walking to my locker, and then my teacher had marked me absent. No, she marked me as skipping class. And one of my friends that was in my health room was also in my homeroom. She marked both of us as skipping class. Baby, I wasn't skipping class, first of all. It was an emergency. So I tried to tell her that. I was like, I was talking to my teacher. Because I didn't want to tell my teacher that. I was like, I was talking to my teacher about my grades. So why is that marked as skipping class? She was like, you didn't have a pass and your teacher didn't email me. So then I went to her office. I said, can you please email my teacher and tell her that I was with you? And she was like, yeah, I got it. And then so she emailed her. And still to this day, my homeroom teacher is one of my favorite teachers. I know that she marked me as skipping class, but then again, she didn't know. But anyways, so it was winter. I still had my jacket wrapped around. I had my coat on. I'm so glad my coat was long. It was a long coat. So I was just, I had to walk home, y'all. Walk home after school. But I lived like right by the school. But like, I was walking home. I had my winter coat on, walking by myself. I think I had my hood on. I was just walking, like, trying to hurry up and get home so I can get changed and take a shower. I'm walking with my long coat on, my hood on, my hands in my pockets. Right there on the corner, it was a fight. These two girls was fighting. It was boys that was fighting. I don't remember. So they was fighting, and so y'all know them school fights, and somebody's fighting, everybody around comes to the fight to see it, and I'm sitting there like, can y'all hurry up? I need to get home. But then again, I was like, I was trying to watch the fight, but I was also trying to get home, and they was in my way. I'm like, okay, I'm trying to walk around y'all. I almost got hit by the fight because I'm trying to hurry up and get home. Anyway, so I had got home. I had took a shower, changed everything. Y'all, when I tell y'all, I think this was the most embarrassing story of my life, I think. I'm sorry, this video is probably short, long, maybe. I don't know. But I'm not good at telling stories, so I hope y'all don't expect another story time from me. I don't even do stuff in my life. But anyway, that is my story time on how I bled through my tan pants in school. I'm so happy that it was one of the last hours of the day, because if that hadn't happened in first hour, I would have went home anyways while I'm talking. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. This is Vlogmas Day 2. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Follow my social medias down below in the description box. And I will see you guys in Vlogmas Day 3.